Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for January the 6th of 2020, well, it is titled Tumultuous Clouds of Jupiter. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image taken by the Juno spacecraft, which is currently in orbit around Jupiter and at present scheduled to remain in orbit throughout this year and into the following year through 2021. And it is studying Jupiter up close in what we call a polar orbit. So it is actually flying over the poles of Jupiter and giving us a different view of the planet. It also is in a very elliptical orbit, and that means it comes in really close to Jupiter and then spends a lot of time very far out. And that is a result of what is known as Kepler's second law of planetary motion, that says that objects move very quickly when they're close to a source of strong gravity and slowly when they're further away. So when it comes in close, it spends a very short time in the dangerous radiation belts of Jupiter, but does give us some very good up-close looks at the planet. And also further away, it has spent a lot more time further away, which is well out of the dangerous radiation belts around the largest planet in the solar system. Now, it has been giving us some great information about Jupiter. We can see some of the different colors, dark and light areas. When we look at Jupiter's equatorial regions, we get alternating dark and light bands, and we get a little more structure and interesting structure as we look closer to the poles. So it looks a little bit different than the alternating bands that we can see off towards the edge of the image here. And we've also made, again, a new discovery that it looks like what we used to consider the gas giant planets, the four gas giants planet of the solar system, the outer four, we used to always consider them to be primarily made of gas. And it is looking like none of them are really made of gas anymore, that Jupiter and Saturn are actually primarily liquid. So they're under the high enough pressure that instead of a gas, they actually have liquids down towards their central regions. And the two outer planets, Uranus and Neptune, are actually icy planets inside. So there may not be any gas giant planets, although they do have some gaseous atmospheres, such as Jupiter here. They all have some gas, but when you get deep inside, there is a lot more liquid there and a lot more ice in the outer two planets than there is gas. So Juno will continue to study these over the coming year as it continues to bring in very close orbits, in this case only about 15,000 kilometers above the clouds of Jupiter. We sometimes say the surface of Jupiter, but Jupiter really does not have a solid surface such as a planet like Mars or the Earth. Jupiter is pretty much gaseous and then compressed down into liquid, and that is about it until you get down to a very central core. And under the very high pressures, those liquids, those gases are compressed to really, really high densities. And when you get down to the core, yes, there is some rock and metal there, but not a surface in the way we think about it, and not something that we could ever begin to approach because we'd never be able to make it through the intense pressures and temperatures that exist further out. So that was our picture of the day for January the 6th of 2020. It was titled Tumultuous Clouds of Jupiter. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Star Flame. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.